Hi friends, welcome to new session of topic counters in PLC. In last sessions, we have studied topics of introduction to PLC, architecture, basics of ladder diagram programming, relays, timers, and numericals related with it. PLCs are used or they are doing different functions such as logical operations, sequencing, arithmetic, timing, and counters. Out of this, we will take review of one of the important function that is nothing but counting function in PLC. First question is why counters are used. Let's think about packaging of objects into box. When specific number of objects, suppose these are nothing but the objects, we have to pack into the boxes. When specific number of objects are sent to one box, here one selector arm is there. This arm will move and it will shift the object to another box. Means we have to count the number of boxes passing from here to one box. After that, we will shift it to another one. Means here counting operation is taking place. It may be required to count the boxes when specific quantity of boxes will move on one conveyor and they are shifted to another. Here the boxes will come from one side, they are moving to this end. When particular number of count is over, arm will move to this side and it will shift the boxes to another side of the conveyor. Here also we require to count the number of boxes. It may be required to count the cars which are nothing but going into parking lot. Fixed number of cars will go to parking lot and afterwards it is required to close the door. Means we have to count the cars. And afterwards, the closing operation of the door is to be taken. Here also, we require the counting operation. Then what is counters? It is nothing but like mechanical counters. It does the function of counting. It is internal feature of PLC. A counter is program function that counts or increments every time when the input changes from false to true. Means there is no input, condition is false, and whenever there will be some input, that becomes true. When such input changes from false to true, the counter increases by 1. In case of earlier examples, whenever cars are going to the parking lot, when one car will become there, that means it will become true, increment will be 1. Again, when car will pass, it condition is false. New car will come, again it will become, that is condition is true, that means counter will go for 1 more increment. That is nothing but doing the operation of counter. In PLC, counters are of 3 types. Up counter, down counter, and up down counter. Up counter named as CTU, down counter as CTD, and up down counter as CTUD. Okay. Then what is the difference between these? Up counter means the up counter counts up from a current value to preset value. Preset value is nothing but the value up to which we have to count. It is decided by the operator. Suppose the parking person, he has to allow 10 cars to go into the parking lot. That means 10 is nothing but the preset value. Initial value is 0. When first car will go, that is nothing but value equal to 1. Second car will go, that value is nothing but equal to 2. Means from 0 up to that preset value, the counter will count. In the same manner, down counter will count from preset value up to the 0. Means if 10 cars are to be counted, then it will go for counting first 10, 9, 8, up to 1. And at 0, it will reset again to 10. Up and down counter counts the values either up or down from the preset value. Like this, three counters are there: up counter, down counter, and up down counter. The basic difference between up and down counter, our use is nothing but like this. Counting the number of parts produced during a specific work. Initially, the number of components produced are 0. They are going increasing. In this case, we are counting these values from 0 up to the preset value. In case of down counter, example we can take that operator, suppose he is producing the job, he want to know how many jobs are remained. At that time, counter will have preset value initially equal to final value, and as new components will be produced, each that value will be reduced. Means at any moment, the operator will come to know that how many parts are remained to produce. That is nothing but up counter and down counter. Few things about counter function. A counter is nothing but program function that counts every increment when input changes from false to true. If in one scan the input is false and in next scan the input is true, the counter increments. No further count will occur until the input goes false again and then true. Means till and until the first car will pass forward, the next car will not come there. Means till and until again from true to it will go to false and from false to true. Whenever the output will, input will change, the output gets counted by 1. Every counter has its address and a preset number. When the preset number counts, preset number of the counts have been accumulated, the counter becomes true and it can activate next part of the ladder diagram. Counter is shown by such square at which it is written counter up or counter down, CTU or CTD. Then address of the counter is written C5:0, C5:1, like that. Next one is preset value. Preset value is nothing but it is set value of operator by the operator. When the counter gets to the preset value, it makes the done bit equal to true. And it goes on, but it goes on counting. Okay. Accumulator is nothing but it is giving us the information about how many values are counted till this moment. Means it is nothing but giving us current count. There are two bits, CU or CD, that is enable bit and done bit. Enable bit is nothing but count up bit. Whenever the counter is enabled, is started, that bit goes on. Done bit is nothing but when accumulated values will be equal to preset value. Means if 10 cars are to be sent to car parking lot and accumulated value equal to 10, at that time the done bit will turn on. Done bit will turn on means wherever in next ladder diagram done bit will be there, it will change its position or it will be energized and next rung of the ladder diagram will run. One more option is there, that is nothing but reset. It is separate instruction with the same counter address. When this bit goes true, when reset is operated, the accumulator resets to 0. Means reset the counter. Means whatever accumulated value will be there, it will become equal to 0. Here, one simple ladder diagram is shown in which input switch, which is nothing but input coming from some sensor, is provided. It is connected, suppose, to input terminal IN1. Same switch is shown here as normally open switch. This is nothing but up counter C5:1. Set value or preset value equal to 5. Accumulated or current value is nothing but equal to 0. Okay. Output is connected to some actuator. Okay. Means our target is whenever this switch will give us 5 number of inputs, 5 number of times this switch will get operated, the actuator will start and counter will give us the count equal to 5. The done bit is shown here as normally open switch and it is connecting to the out 1, which is nothing but the actuator. Okay. Here reset switch is provided. When this switch will be operated, the reset switch shown here will get connected and it will reset the counter CTU1, means the same counter 1, it will get reset. Let's see how it takes place. Now, same diagram is there. Input switch, if once it is made on, this switch get connected, counted value increased by 1. Okay. Again, switch is pressed, counted value increased to input is given more, counted value is 3rd. When 4th car will come, sensor will give input equal to 4. Again, input switch will operate, accumulated value equal to 5. Now, preset value and accumulated value are same. Done bit will be activated. When done bit is activated, this gets closed and output is started. That is nothing but the actuator is started. In this way, when number of times equal to preset value, the input is given, the output got actuated and counter has counted that value. When reset switch is pressed, this reset got operated and again accumulated value equal to 0. Means again it will go for 5 number of counts and again actuator will be on. In this diagram, the input switch is nothing but the sensor used for counting of the objects. In first case, whatever the objects were moving, they were counted by some proximity sensor. Whenever boxes were moving on conveyor, that boxes, there may be some input switch, that is nothing but some limit switch or some proximity sensor. Whenever cars are passing, there may be some proximity sensor. That proximity sensor is nothing but this input switch. Same switch is shown here. Now, let's go for example. Draw a ladder diagram for a packaging system where 10 objects are to be allowed to go to container 1. When 10 objects will get filled in that container, then they are to be shifted to container 2 by a selector arm. User will reset it when both the containers are filled. Now, the problem is related with counters. 10 number of objects are to be counted. They are counted from value 0 up to this. Then, whenever they are moving on conveyor, there will be one selector arm which is run by some motor, and it will shift, that selector arm will shift it to the next conveyor. Pictorial view is nothing but like this. One motor, it is nothing but running this conveyor belt system. Objects are moving on the conveyor. Presence of the object is detected by this sensor, this proximity sensor. And proximity sensor will act as one input switch to the PLC. It is connected to input card. This proximity sensor will be normally open. That is nothing but false condition. When object will come here, sensor will sense the object, it will change to true position, means it will get closed. Okay. When another object will come, again it will sense, again it will go to true value. Means sensor is nothing but acting as the input switch here to the PLC. Okay. Then when ladder diagram will be completed, output is produced. That output is given to the motor which rotates the arm. When 10 number of objects will go to collector 1, box 1, the arm will get moved and it will shift the next object to collector 2. Here one setting will be there in front of operator. Start means it will start the motor. Stop, at any moment he should stop the motor and the conveyor system. Then he has to count the number of objects equal to 10, and whenever this task will be completed, he will go for resetting of the system. Now with ladder diagram, let's see how it takes place. In this ladder diagram, these two are nothing but the vertical rungs, power supply lines. Okay, start switch is nothing but this one, which is connected to IN 0. Same start switch is shown here as normally open switch. Means for this first rung, start switch whenever it gets closed, the latch coil, which is nothing but out 0. This is nothing but port, out 0. This is nothing but the latch coil. It will run. Stop switch, it is connected to IN 2, which is nothing but this stop switch, which is normally closed. Start switch is normally open, stop switch is normally closed. Okay. Now, the sensor which was detecting the objects, it was nothing but the proximity switch. It is used as one push button here. Okay. Means this push button is getting connected, or whenever it is left, it go to original position. It is connected here to IN1. Counter used is nothing but this, which is up type of counter. C5:1. Preset value equal to 10. Accumulated value equal to 0. Okay. Now this proximity switch is used here as normally open switch. Okay. And in the same line, this latch coil is there. Means when start switch is pressed, this latch will be started and this counter rung will be ready for the operation. Once this start switch is pressed, it will get closed. Accumulated value will be increased by 1. Our target is it should reach to 10. Okay. Then this out 0 means nothing but latch value. Done bit of this counter is shown as normally open here. And it is rung is nothing but terminating in out 1. Out 1 is nothing but the motor of the selector arm. Then a reset is nothing but switch connected here, IN4, which will reset the same counter. That is nothing but CTU 1. This is reset so that accumulated value will become equal to again 0. Okay. Stop switch is provided here, normally open switch, which will go for unlatching the initial coil so that out 0, where we will connect the motor of the conveyor system, that will nothing but get stopped. Okay. Now let's see how it happens. Okay. When the start switch will be pressed, this will get connected. Either I will go for this or this. Okay. When this is pressed, start switch is pressed, here this rung is now ready. Okay. Proximity sensor, whenever proximity sensor will be made on, accumulated value is increased by 1, because it got connected, supply is available here and counter has counted value 1. Okay. When again proximity sensor will be connected, next object will come, accumulated value equal to 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay. When this value became 10, done bit is energized or become true. Here this done bit gets closed and hence out 1, that is nothing but selector arm motor, is nothing but started. Okay. Means when 10 number of times the proximity sensor will sense the objects, every time it will get closed, it will become true. It will increase the counter value by 1 and counter will give, counter done bit will get activated and output actuator will be there. Okay. Now, when we want to reset this system, we will go for this push button reset so that this reset will get closed and resetting of the counter will take place. It will go to 0. Okay. Means accumulator value becomes 0 and motor is stopped, because this done bit get again to original condition. Okay. Now suppose we will go for counting some values and we want to stop the system immediately. There is nothing but this stop switch, okay, shown by this symbol for the user. When it will be pressed, stop switch will get connected, it will unlatch the coil, okay, and the coil got unlatched and hence first motor and next all the rungs will be disabled. In this way the counter functions. Thank you very much for your patience listening. Please subscribe for next information of the videos. Thank you.